Hello and welcome. Thanks for joining us. Major League Baseball on tap. It's the Seattle Mariners and the Los Angeles Angels. First pitch coming at you right after the break. Almost ready to get underway. And towing the slab in this one, Carson Fulmer.
Well, they're going with the opener in this one, so this is an interesting look. He's probably only going to pitch an inning, maybe two at the most, and it's going to be unconventional. I think he's going to pitch backwards, more off speed, and then fastballs late.
All right, ready to go here. And stepping in for the Mariners, Victor Robles. Victor Robles. The pitch. The pitch out there. One out in the top of the first.
Well, that's a curveball that I'm sure he wants back at the plate. Two strikes, the sort of pitch you're hoping for. A bit of a mistake, and I'd say in a very hittable location, but clearly the break was enough to get him to swing through it.
Now it's Randy Arozarena. And misses. That's out number two.
He came out of his mechanics there. Typically likes to shoot the ball the other way, but that time a little anxious.
Cal Raleigh up next for the Mariners. Two down, nobody on. Got him. Strikes out the side to begin the game. What a start. M's nothing. Angels coming up. It's Major League Baseball on the show. Back here with my pal Siggy, and towing the slab in this one, George Kirby.
Great sinker. Although it's not his primary pitch, it's really a pitch that he can go to. Misses the barrel of the bat, gets ground balls, and lets the defense work behind him.
Bottom of the first. Here's Anthony Rendon up to the plate.
The third baseman, Anthony Rendon.
And a pitch. Swing and a base hit. So a man on base to start the inning.
Couldn't have timed it up any better than that. Anytime you rip a line drive the other way, you feel really good about what you did at the plate. You trusted your hands, you let the ball travel, and you took the barrel straight to it. That's great work right there.
Nolan Schanuel, the next to hit for the Angels. And here it comes. They won 95 to finish him off. Now the left fielder, Taylor Ward. The pitch. Swing and a miss. Get a count one and two.
One ball, two strikes.
Kicks and deals. Blows the high heat past him. That's a strikeout.
Well, interesting. He's looking very comfortable out of the stretch after giving up the leadoff single. Back-to-back strikeouts. So they haven't been able to move that runner up, get him into scoring position, and try to have a better chance of scoring. I tell you, good job so far on the mound. He just needs one more out.
And here's the catcher, Logan Ohapi. Next offering upstairs.
2-1.
Wouldn't chase that time.
Three balls, one strike.
Two outs and a foul ball.
Great RBI spot here. Just got to stay focused on the pitch. The runner will be in motion, so something in the gap should definitely score it.
Gets a piece and stays alive. Rendon off of first with two away. Foul. We'll see another payoff pitch. And they'll do it again. Payoff pitch.
Three.
Got him. He battled for a long time, but it finishes with a strikeout. You can't be mad at yourself after an at-bat like that one. Angels strand one. We played an inning. No score. Back here at Angel Stadium. Second inning set to go. And now the center fielder, Julio Rodriguez. And the pitch. And a swing and a miss. Looks like he's picked up right where he left off.
Yeah, there's a small sigh of relief right there. I mean, just to keep that speed off the base paths, it's not just the pitcher. It's other guys that have to think about it. From your infielders, have to think about that runner potentially stealing, but also be in position to make a play. As an outfielder, you're thinking about a base hit to the outfield. I got to get to it quickly to try to keep this guy from taking an extra base. So I think everyone just a little more relaxed that he didn't reach base.
One ball.
Here's Turner now. And the righty deals.
Ball
and there's
two.
A ball. Eric Summersgill with home plate duty in this one. Kind of known for being generous with the corners, Chris.
You know, I think that used to be a lot bigger deal in past eras where pitchers were working more in and out with their pitches. But, yeah, we'll see if those corners come into play in this one. Hey, no pitcher's going to argue at all.
That three, one two. Just misses.
Really good take, especially with two strikes.
Now fly ball to right center. On the move. Makes the catch for the out.
That is it. The second base.
The batter now, Jorge Polanco.
Polanco.
The pitch.
Two balls, one strike.
Bounced up the middle. Neto sends it to first. And Polanco is out. Third out, and that ends the frame. Nobody left for Seattle. We'll go to the bottom of the second. No score. Back in Anaheim, bottom of the second. And here is Willie Calhoun.
Willie Calhoun.
The 1-1 is fouled off. The wind of the pitch. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. And there's one down.
Well, he's really dialed in, and this offense is going to have to do something to try to break that rhythm. Maybe it's square around the bunt, step out of the box, agitate him a little bit, do something that just changes what's happening right now, because at this pace it's going to be a long game, so you got to figure it out quickly.
So digging in, Zach Neto. Late on that fastball.
One ball, two strikes.
One down, base is empty. That one missing inside. Second inning here, no score. Hawaii to kick the pitch. That one just misses, and a full count now. Swings, threw it, and that's a strikeout.
Well, right now, he's in cruise control, autopilot, just dominating these hitters. It doesn't look like it's a fun at bat. And all of a sudden, you become in awe of this guy on the mound. Somebody's got to break this thing up. That's five straight strikeouts. He's got to put a ball in play.
And next for L.A., Mickey Moniak. And that one lifted in the air center field. Rodriguez moving under it and makes the play, and that's out number three. We'll move to the third with no score. And we're back. And here's the first baseman, Luke Raley.
Luke Raley.
The 1-1. Hot shot to third. Rendon throw to first. And a quick out number one. Here's Dylan Moore. Right-hander kicks, deals. Fought off foul. One out, base is empty. Right side, hard hit. Shanawell steps on the bag. First two batters retired here in the top of the third.
Batting on the third base is number four.
Here's Josh Rojas. Two down, nobody on, and a foul ball. Left-hand hitter waits, and a foul ball. He stays alive. Next offering way off the plate. Just misses with that one.
Caught a break right there. Pretty good pitch in the outside corner.
Two outs. Line drive. That's a base hit out of the left center field.
Now bad.
And now it's Victor Robles up to hit. The 1-1. And another ball. Rojas leads off first with two down to the inning. That one misses. 3-1. Randy Arozarena up next. Three-one now. Comes up empty. That's strike two. Three and two. Payoff pitch. On the ground, right side. Tosses to first, and that will end the inning. Mariners lead one, and we are still scoreless. Welcome back to the ballpark. Brandon Drury to the plate.
The second baseman, Brandon Drury.
The line of the pitch. Up and in, and the count is even, 2-2. That one lifted to left. The Arozarena after it. Puts it away for the out.
Batting ninth, the right fielder.
Here's Joe Adell. One down, base is empty. Hard ground ball, base now. So the lineup flips over. Anthony Rendon making his way to the plate.
Two.
Got him. Two gone.
Now back. First base.
Nolan Schanuel, the next to hit for the Angels. Still tied at zero, last of the third. Though Chris, through the early stages, he hasn't been very efficient in terms of the pitch count. He's going to need to get some quick outs if he's going to get deep into this game. And that'll put runners at the corners with two away. And next for the Angels, Taylor Ward. Ball to strike, the pitch. That's inside. Corners are occupied with two down. Down the line. Robles on the run towards the line. Tries to make the play, but it's foul. Two on, two outs. He just misses there.
Definitely got the hitter conscious of the pitch inside. Really think the outer half is open.
Logan Ohapi on deck for the Angels. Swing and a miss, and that is that. Angels strand a couple, still no score. Randy Arozarena up next for the Mariners.
Randy Arozarena.
And that's in the dirt. Ripped, base hit. Man aboard on the leadoff single.
He was all over that one. Showed a willingness to drive that pitch the opposite way. Didn't get jumpy, didn't try to pull the ball. He let it get deep, took the barrel right to it, and then extended through the swing for the line drive base hit.
Go ahead, run on base. Here's the power hitting catcher, Cal Raleigh. And now the count, one and two after the swing and the miss.
Well, here's a good opportunity in this inning to get on the scoreboard after that leadoff hit, and Harvey Orter coming up right behind him. This is where they need to get going.
Here's a 1-2. And that one missing low.
With two strikes, may see some movement over there at first base, trying to stay out of the double play right here.
Now one away.
Good pitch right there. I mean, he's attacking a location that this guy at the plate tends to have trouble with. And there's just so much information in this day and age, sometimes too much information. But the guys that can take that information, process it, and then go out there, Boog, and execute the pitch, go right after that hitter and get the result that they were anticipating, that's really good pitching right there. And it's a good job of the pitcher and the catcher working together.
The 1-1 is fouled off. And Chris Harris. That's a way to neutralize his speed by keeping him on base.
And the defense breathes a sigh of relief because he puts pressure on everyone if he can put the ball in play. But that's how you do it. Keep him off balance, get him out of there, and deal with the next guy.
And it'll bring up Justin Turner. That misses the zone, and a count 2-1. Move to first. Rosarena dives back. And that drops in for a strike. Fourth inning underway, no score. And this is inside.
3-2, two out, runner on first. A lot of movement in the infield. Hitter's got to stay focused on the pitch.
Jorge Polanco up next for the Mariners. Two outs. Fouled off again, and it remains 3-2. That one back up the middle, and it gets through. Lead runner makes the turn at second. And now they'll have runners on the corners with two away.
Man, that was a pretty good battle at the plate. And I'll tell you, it feels pretty good as a hitter when you grind out a hit like that. Timing on the swing was good. Able to shoot the ball up the middle. Didn't square it up as much as he probably would have liked, but that's a good approach paying off. Runner in scoring position now, and a good opportunity to push across the first run of the ballgame.
And now it's the switch inning second baseman, Jorge Polanco. Two on, two outs. And a count 1-2. Kicks and fires. Out to short, Neto. Got him on the off-balance throw. That's the third out. Mariners leave a couple, and we're still knotted at zero. Four, and now it's the Angels cleanup bat. Logan O'Hoppe. Righty delivers. And now the count is even.
2-2 the count.
Swing and a miss for the strikeout. Slider got him for strike three.
Wow, just great bite to that slider. Broke hard out of the zone, and he just couldn't hold up the swing. You know, as a hitter, that pitch is really hard to take, and there's just not much you can do with it. You know that, but you don't want to get rung up by the umpire.
Willie Calhoun stands in here. Next offering is down low. Eighth pitch of the at-bat coming up. In the air, right center. This is mashed way back and gone. A gigantic blast. And they jump out front. It's 1-0. He kept swinging, and it paid off.
Well, that was a battle, Boog, and he just kept taking his cuts. Finally squared one up. Knew what pitch he wanted to hit. Spit on some other pitches in this at bat. Was very patient, and it paid off.
bases empty, one away. Zach Neto, the next to hit for the Angels. Next offering upstairs. One down, base is empty. On the ground to the left, Rojas throws the first in time.
Center field, number 16, Mickey.
Two outs, base is empty. Mickey Moniak, the next to hit for the Angels. Two outs, base is empty. This one in the air. Under this one. And that ends the inning. Halos strike first with the solo shot. It's now a 1-0 ball game. Major League Baseball is on the show. We're back, and there's a new arm on the mound to start the fifth, Mike Bauman. And he'll feature a hard slider to work off his fastball.
Number 53, Mike Bauman.
And now the first baseman, Luke Raley.
The first baseman, Luke Raley.
The pitch. Action in the Angels bullpen. Matt Moore preparing to come on if needed. Pochanowicz also throwing. And another ball. This one in the air. Gets under it. Makes the grab, one down.
That was a good hard fastball with some nice ride up in the zone right there. Hitter looked like he was on it, but I think that velocity at the end just beat him. Instead of a line drive or something hit deep, it's a pop up and an easy out for the defense.
Strike two.
I think he was sitting off speed.
One ball, two strikes.
Base is empty, one away, and we're at the top of the fifth. Righty to the plate. And that's in the dirt. And that's ball two. That's hard hit on the line. Ward pulls it down, and there's two gone. So up next, Josh Rojas. And that one fouled off. Not even close there. Two and two. Next offering is outside. Good battle here. About to be the eighth pitch of the at bat. On the ground, right side, Shanuel. He takes it himself to the bag, and that'll do it. Mariners go down quietly there. They trail here 1-0. By bottom of the inning. So in now for the Angels, Brandon Drury. And a swing and a miss. Some activity in the Mariners bullpen. Trent Thornton appears to be getting ready for manager Scott Servais. Both warming up as well. Here comes a pitch. Foul ball still, 1-2 count. Goes down looking.
It's almost like he's telling the guys in the bullpen, stand down, I got this.
The right fielder, number 7.
And now the right fielder, Joe Adell. And the pitch. So a foul ball makes it 1-2. One down, base is empty. Spoils the two-strike pitch, and he'll see another. And another ball.
You could see he was trying to stay back long enough to handle the off-speed pitch, but just a little tardy on the fastball.
Eighth pitch of the at-bat coming up.
Five foul balls in this at-bat so far, and these two are going head-to-head. You can see the crowd. They're starting to get into it a little bit more and more each pitch, even though there hasn't been a ball in play yet.
And here it comes. Misses off the plate, and now it's 3-2. Got him looking. That's a strikeout.
Really good battle right there. And that final pitch probably could have gone either way. He was hoping he'd get ball four. Instead, the umpire rings him up for the backwards K.
Back to the top of the Angels lineup. Now the third baseman, Anthony Rendon. Two down, nobody on. Swing and a miss, and that's strike two.
One ball, two strikes.
That ball misses, two. And it's 2-2. Caught him looking for the K. Angels go quietly there. They lead it 1-0. Top six, and now Victor Robles. Swing and a miss. That is strike two. Activity in the bullpen for the Angels. Matt Moore, the left-hander, up and throwing. The 1-2. Now one miss. Foul ball, another 2-2 upcoming. Swung on, belted. Out of here. A home run off the foul pole. He powers that one out of here. And we're starting over. It's 1-1.
That swing completely changes the momentum of this game, Boog. This thing was hooking down the line the entire way. We knew it was going to be close, and bang, right off the left field pole. That was a pretty swing, and he found a way to keep his hands inside just enough to keep it fair.
Yeah, there's a ball.
But you just got to delete it. You give up that leadoff home run, go back to work, focus on this next batter.
Nobody on, nobody out, and we're at the top half of the sixth.
The real threats are coming up, already giving up a home run in this inning. It's going to really have to bear down.
And a 2-2.
That's
a little bit low.
He should get a pretty good pitch to hit here with three-hole hitter coming up if he's walked.
Back to work, 3-2 now. Fouls it back with two strikes. Bangs and misses, it's a strikeout.
He's got to throw any pitch in any count, 3-2, he goes off speed, gets the out.
Here's the catcher to hit, Cal Raleigh. And a pitch. And another ball. Spoils that one, and it remains 2-2. One down, base is empty. That's down and in. Swing and a miss, and he is down on strikes for the third straight at bat.
Tough night at the dish, punching out for the third time right there. He just hasn't looked very comfortable at the plate. A little unsure of his timing right now, not picking up the spin and location of these pitches. He'll have some adjustments to make.
And that's off the inside edge. And it's 2-1. Foul ball there.
Instead of letting the hitter get his arms extended, tied him up a little bit, slightly up, slightly in.
Runs it up to 96 to record the punch out. The Mariners pick up a run thanks to this solo homer. All even at one apiece. Back down for the bottom of the sixth, and there's a new pitcher on the mound, number 59. So digging in, Nolan Schanuel.
The first baseman, Nolan Schanuel.
1-1 now. That one hammered, but pulled foul. Right-handed reliever. Fights that one away, still 1-2. And a good eye there.
It's a good take.
Two balls, two strikes.
That one misses. Full count now. Three. And a swing and a miss. One down.
Man, there was no deviating from the fastball right there. He just kept coming after him with it. Here it is. Hit it if you can. And he just couldn't find a way to put it in play.
Taylor Ward, the next to hit for the Angels. Swing and a miss. And it's 1-2.
Wow, no fair right there. I mean, that slider didn't move till the very last moment. Incredibly difficult to pick that up. Just kind of have to tip your cap on that pick.
And now it's 1-2 upstairs. Bounce to the left side. Rojas throws on to first. Two up, two down.
The catcher number 14. Logan Ohapi.
Here's the Angels catcher, Logan Ohapi. And another ball.
One strike.
The pitch. Fastball for a strike.
Two balls, two strikes.
Two outs. Out towards right center. That's well struck. Here. He'll touch them all. Just like that, they move in front. It's 2-1.
The one thing the pitcher didn't want to happen just happened. That's not an easy one to stomach. Looks like he's playing wiffle ball up there, and that's typically not the easiest way to hit a home run. To the slight opposite field, into the gap. Man, making it look easy, that's for sure.
Base is empty with two away. Now it's going to be Willie Calhoun. Left-hand batter waits. And strike two.
One ball, two strikes.
A 1-2. Three. Swings through that one. It's a strikeout. One scores in the inning coming on this solo home run. And it's now a 2-1 ball game. Welcome back. We're in the seventh. We have a new pitcher on the mound, Roansy Contreras.
These are the spots relievers really make a name for themselves, late and close. There's not much margin for error, but at the same time, there's a reason they're put in these situations.
Looking to get the tying run on base. And that's ball four.
It's tough after falling behind a hitter, two balls and no strikes, but now at least he gets a fresh start against a new batter. But he needs to get back into the strike zone and start pitching with conviction.
And the slider just misses.
Two balls, one strike.
Good eye right there.
Well, in this count, runner not known for his speed, but I think you got to put him in motion. Try to avoid a double play here, Boo.
And the right-hander deals. Two low, ball four, and he's walked another.
Walks out of the bullpen can absolutely kill your momentum very quickly. They're in some hot water trying to protect this lead.
Luke Raley up next for the Mariners. This is what stat nerds like myself might call a high leverage situation.
Yeah, Boog, not sure what the numbers say, but clearly an at bat that could change the course of this game dramatically. Could be some action here on this next pitch. Couple runners on, probably a challenge pitch coming.
And a 2-1 hammered but foul. So the tying run at second. Hits and misses. It's a strikeout.
So far, just one of those days for this lineup. You get a couple of runners on, and you're looking at having a big inning. And that strikeout right there just pours water on the fire. Look for the next hitter to step up.
Righty reliever out of the pen, number 52.
Well, the best relievers love the opportunity to come in and protect a tight lead late in the ball game. Some of them are just wired different, so we'll see what he's got here.
And the batter now, Dylan Moore. Swing and a miss. Nice changeup.
The last thing he wants is to hit the ball on the ground, but I wouldn't expect many pitches up in the zone. They'll be pitching for a double play in this spot.
The 1-2. Rolled to short. Possible two ball. There's one.
Out.
And that's quick work out of the pen. One batter, two outs, inning over.
Got the batter to hit it exactly where he wanted. That textbook 6-4-3 double play gets out of the jam and back in the dugout.
Back in Anaheim, set for the last half of the seventh. Stepping in, Zach Neto. And a 1-1. High drive, base hit. And the leadoff man aboard.
Just so sound in his mechanics. Hits against a firm front side, and the hands just continue to carry through the middle of the field.
So, man aboard, and next for LA, Mickey Moniak. Got him to chase one upstairs there.
One ball, two strikes.
Keeps the at-bat going with a foul ball. Swing and a miss. Got him to go up the ladder for the K.
Boat gets talked about a lot, but a good high fastball in a two-strike situation, it's just become such a problem for hitters in more recent years. But with all of the emphasis by pitchers on developing that spin rate, having a good grip on the baseball, those high fastballs, they kind of look like to the hitter that they're rising, even though they're not, but they're not decreasing in velocity and spin rate, so very difficult to get the barrel on.
Now, Brandon Drury. Move to first. Ground ball left side could be two. Rojas over to second, and that's two. One hit in the inning, but no one left. Eighth inning coming up. Angels 2 and the Mariners 1. Ready to begin the eighth. Here's the third baseman, Josh Rojas. Turns the lineup over.
Always feels amazing getting a job done when a team needs you to come through. It's just bigger than your own individual stats. Mitchell's on the outside, didn't go the other way with it, but still a nice job of using the big part of the field to find the hole. No way he hits it that well if he hooks around the baseball.
Here's Victor Robles. And a count 1-2. Trying to hold a one-run lead, and we're in the top of the eighth. Next pitch misses way outside. Meanwhile, activity in the bullpen. And Joyce, the closer of the staff, is getting loose to finish this one off. Quijada getting cranked up as well. The pitch. Swinging. One gone here. New pitcher in the game for the Angels, Hunter Strickland.
Now pitching for the Angels, number 61, Hunter Strickland.
Strickland. Randy Arozarena up next for the Mariners.
Well, with pretty good speed over there at first base, I think the pitcher's got to slow everything down. Hold the ball a little bit, step off, just try to break the rhythm and timing of a potential base dealer. He's got plus speed, but in this situation, all eyes are going to be over there trying to keep his lead tight.
Ground ball left side, could be two. One at second, double play. They can't seem to break through. Inning over. No runs, one hit, no errors, and no one left. Home half of inning number eight straight ahead. Angels two and the Mariners one. So coming into the game now on defense, Leonardo Rivas. He's the new third baseman. New pitcher for the Mariners, Trent Thornton.
Just trying to keep this one close here, and this is where a bullpen can give their players a chance to fight back into the game.
Now at the plate,
and
Joe Adell.
For the Angels, the right fielder, Joe Adell.
Kicks and deals. Adell started after it, tried to hold up. Now a look to first. No swing, says Freddie Ferguson. Next offering in there for a strike. It's 2-2.
Well, that's that slurve right there. He threw it extremely well. Talk about just a ton of breaks. So tough to get that barrel to.
2-2 on the way.
3-2.
On the ground, right side. The flip to the pitcher covering, and that's one away as the leadoff man is out in the eighth. So the batting order turns over. Next to hit, Anthony Rendon. Base is empty, one away. Here, the bottom half of the eighth inning. Swing and a ball popped up. Polanco under it. Hauls it in for the out.
The batter. The first baseman. Nolan. Schanuel.
Two outs, base is empty. Now the number two hitter, Nolan Schanuel. The pitch. And he chases a high fastball there.
Wow, good luck catching up to that one.
In the air to left down the line. And that drops foul. And it's ball four. He missed down low.
One of the things about that two-out walk, the base runner over at first base is going to have a very aggressive secondary lead. So a ball down the line or into the gap will produce a two-out RBI, and those are the best. That is if you are the offensive side of it.
And the pitch. Swing and a miss.
One ball, two strikes.
Outside. The count now 2-2. Schanuel, the runner at first with two gone. And a swing and a miss. And that's that. Angels leave one as they're unable to add to their 2-1 lead. back now, and on the mound, the closer, Joyce.
Well, he's the guy they hope to turn to out of the pen to lock down wins. So this game has gone to plan, more or less. Let's see if he can wrap it up here.
Here's a 1-1. And that one fouled off. Strikeout for the first out here in the ninth.
Well, he throws him with a great fastball right on the corner. It's kind of like bowling when you think the ball's going to get into the gutter and somehow just hangs onto that edge and knocks down a pin. Well, he got the outside corner of the plate and got that called third strike.
He's two outs away. And now it's Julio Rodriguez. And a base hit right there. So they get a man aboard with a one-out single.
Now that.
We all saw his hit hard, but how hard was it, Singy? StatCast is here with the answer.
Yeah, Boog, it says the exit velo was 113 miles per hour, and it looked every bit of it, didn't it? I mean, just an impressive swing of the bat, and clearly he saw it out of the pitcher's hand no problem.
Now it's Justin Turner, and fouled off. A strikeout.
And he'll be beating himself up on the way back to the dugout. He got a pitch to hit and just couldn't get to it. I think that slider really caught way more of the plate than it was supposed to.
So last chance for the Mariners. Now a chance for Jorge Polanco. Just missed.
Right now they're looking for something hit hard into the gaps. Give them an opportunity with two outs to score that run from first.
One run game here at the top of the ninth. Runner on the go. It's ball in three. The dirt. Throw. Save. That was close, but StatCast shows us why he so often seems to be on the safe side of these steal attempts, Chris.
Yeah, you see that plus speed, and he needed every last bit of it to swipe that bag. Such a threat on the bases.
So the tying run at second, and there's ball four.
Pretty much the last thing you want from your bullpen arms are free passes, especially in spots like this. Make the team earn their way off.
Luke Raley up next for the Mariners. Big spot. Two out. Both the tying and go-ahead runs are aboard. Rips one to right. Base hit. Here's Rodriguez trying to score. Throw is offline, and he scores. It's 2-2.
Well, a big swing of the bat right there. Got a fastball, middle of the plate, jumped all over. Absolutely smoked that ball. Now that sets up a huge at bat in this ballgame.
So the Angels turn to their bullpen for a new pitcher, Jack Kochanowicz. First and second, two outs. Dylan Moore up next for the Mariners. Two on, two outs. Up the middle, and he knocks it down. And they get the out after the ricochet. And that is that. So one run in the inning on this base hit. And we're deadlocked now at two apiece. You're dialed into the show. Back now as they hand the ball to a fresh arm to start the bottom of the ninth. Austin Voth.
Now pitching for the Mariners. Number 30, Austin Voth.
And now the catcher comes up to him. Logan Ohapi.
The catcher. Logan Ohapi.
The 1-1. The other way, and a base hit. Leadoff knock puts the winning run on base.
Everything came together for him. Nice job of driving that pitch the other way on the line. You know, hitters, they take so many reps in the cages working on going to the opposite field, and it doesn't always translate into the game, but right there it did, and he did it perfectly.
Next is the designated hitter, Willie Calhoun. In the dirt, and the runner stays where he is. With the winning run on at first, here in the last half of inning number 9. Swings through the fastball up in the zone. Action in the pen down there. Andres Munoz appears to be getting ready for manager Scott Servais. Saucedo, the lefty, warming up as well. The 2-2 on the way. Gets a piece there, we'll do it again. At the belt and fires. Hit hard, that gets through. Lead runner around second, and it'll be first and third now after that miscue. A perfect example right there. That plate discipline, it pays off.
The deeper he gets into a count, the more comfortable he becomes, and he usually wins the battle.
So a change being made at first base. Entering is the pinch runner, Kevin Pillar. So runners at the corners, nobody out. Zach Neto now at the plate. Right-hander kicks, deals. Ground ball could be two. Over to Polanco. They get one. Relay to first, double play.
The 5-4-3 double play is a gem in baseball. And how can you not appreciate the skill and practice it takes to make this look so easy? Great work by the infield.
And next for the Angels, Mickey Moniak. Trying to send this extra innings. Swings and misses. And the count is 1-2. Two outs. And that one is inside. Just missed.
That's a really good take.
Brandon Drury hitting on deck circle. The pitch. Up the middle. That's the third out, and we're headed to extras. Angels strand one. Score remains deadlocked at 2-2. And we're back on to extra innings. And now for Seattle, Leonardo Rivas. And it's second. Just missed. And the righty deals. Swings through the fastball up in the zone. Swing and a miss and a changeup in the dirt. In time. And the drop third strike leads to the first out. And an excellent job keeping it right there.
Well, that at bat seemed to be over as soon as it started. Three-pitch strikeout. You've got to be better at the plate right there. At least to foul something off, extend that at bat.
And up next for Seattle, Victor Robles. Front and foul to the left side. One out. The go-ahead run is its second. Here are the top half of the 10th. Swing and he popped it up. On his way over. Flashes the leather and the run at catch. Two down.
Now the left hander. Randy Arozarena.
Randy Arozarena up next for the Mariners. The pitch. Tapped at the plate, but it's a foul ball. Two down, go-ahead run in scoring position here in extra innings. Fly ball to right. Pulls it down and he makes the catch. And that's the third out.
A lot of adrenaline, we can see it right there. And sometimes you just got to let it out. That's an outstanding job of taking that, executing, and getting out of a tough inning.
So they're making a move for a bat off the bench. Luis Guillorme, a critical at bat this game for him. Righty delivers. And another ball. Righty to the plate. Late that time, and it's strike two. Next offering misses, and it's 3-2. Joe Adell waits on deck. Left-hand hitter waits. Fly ball down the line. Arozarena moving under it. Calls it in, and there's one away.
The right fielder, number 7, Joe Adell.
So in now for the Angels, Joe Adell.
Well, first base open. Really no reason to pitch to this hitter right here. Put him on, have the force at second, first, perhaps getting inning-ending double play.
That's the call. And the count 1-2. Swing and a miss, struck him out.
Came inside with that two-strike fastball nicely and just punched him up on the inside part of the plate. Couldn't get around on it and catch it out front. Many times if you do, it's a foul ball. And you know, a lot of pitchers, they really don't like working inside with two strikes because they do not want to hit that batter. And when they've got him up against the ropes, got to figure out a way to put him away. Did a nice job right there.
Fought off foul. Winning run in scoring position with two away. Next pitch is outside.
Man, oh man, I don't know how you take that pitch. That's as close as it gets.
Swing and a ball popped up. Has a beat on it. And that is the third out of the inning.
That was an opportunity to do damage. He popped it up instead. Frustrating at bat. He'll be thinking about that one for a while.
Here at Angel Stadium, 11th inning set to get underway. Now the Mariners catcher, Cal Raleigh. Man at second, nobody out. Chris, certainly one of the things in his head is trying to get the runner over.
Yeah, the way that we see the game played today, though, guys are not sacrificing as much just to get that runner across. They're really looking at doing damage. Slugging is the name of the game.
Fouls it off, still 1-2. Yeah, I think part of that goes into it's just so hard to come up with hits. In today's game, starters don't go deep. That's ripped into the outfield, and that's a base hit. And they get it in quickly. First and third now with nobody out. So they hold the runner at third, wanting to play it safe. Think that comes back to bite him?
Boy, it's hard to say. That runner on second to start extras is critical, and you want to make sure you don't waste him. If they don't score this inning, there'll be some second guessing for sure.
Go ahead, run on base. So now it's the Mariner cleanup hitter, Julio Rodriguez. Line drive, and that gets a base hit into center field. Runner from third in to score. It's 3-2.
Well done. Drives in the run. That's about as textbook as it gets. Got his stride low, out of the way early. Stayed inside that ball and squared it up out front. Man, that was like he was in the cage hitting off a tee.
Turner climbs in on that right side. And a pitch. And another ball. Here comes a pitch. He swings and hits a fly ball. Center field. Moniak drifts towards it, makes the catch, and there's one gone.
The second baseman, Jorge Polanco.
Now it's the second baseman, Jorge Polanco.
Well, both sides equally as strong, so not a good time to try to turn him around with a relief pitcher and put him on the other side of the plate.
Swing and a miss, and that's strike two. And here it comes. And a curve misses outside. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. Had him out front for strike three.
Perfectly executed 12-6 curveball right there. And with that kind of break, if you can drop it in below the zone like that, it's going to look like a strike the entire way coming in and then just disappear. So hard to get under the ball unless you're really gearing up for it and you might need a pitching wedge.
So first and second with two outs. And stepping in for the Mariners, Luke Raley. The 1-1 is fouled off.
Nothing but curveball so far in the at-bat. Kind of makes it difficult as a hitter to know what to look for because you start wondering if he'll keep coming with it or if they'll try to speed you up.
Got him swinging. One run in the inning, but they leave two. Last shot here as we go to the bottom of the 11th. It's the Mariners 3 and the Angels 2. Back here in extras and a new pitcher on the mound in the bottom half of the inning, Andrés Muñoz.
Now this is an extremely confident pitcher. He loves the pressure. Actually likes the one-run game better than a comfortable three-run save opportunity.
Well, one-run game. Now here is Nolan Schanuel.
Well, comfortable or not, these are the situations closers they seem to live for. I mean, you get into some hot water, a jam, tough spot, whatever you want to call it, but this is where they earn their keep.
So the tying run at second. Still 2-2 after the foul ball. And he deals. Battling here as he fouls it away. Man at second. Taylor Ward up next for the Angels. Payoff pitch. Got him. He didn't make it easy for him on the mound, but they still get the strikeout.
Oh, see it more commonly in the sport these days, but man, a triple-digit fastball blown right by someone is still pretty awesome to witness. I mean, you got to be geared up and ready to swing it when a guy like this comes out of the bullpen because that fastball, it eats, and if you're not ready, you're going to be walking back to the dugout.
Digging in, Taylor Ward.
2 balls, 1 strike.
Kicks and fires. And that one fouled off. Swings and misses, struck him out.
The catcher number 14.
So it's their last chance in this one. And next will be the cleanup hitter, Logan Ohapi. And there's no doubt that they'll feed off the energy from this crowd, right?
I mean, yeah, I'd say the intensity level has gone up a few notches for sure.
The pitch. Swing and a miss. It's a ball and two strikes. One strike away. Swings and misses, struck him out. And that ends the ball game. The tying run left stranded at second.
Well, I love the fact they didn't quit. They had to do a little extra work tonight to secure this win, but it's what you got to do over the course of a season if you want to be a championship ball club.
A 3-2 final score in this one. A one-run extra inning win for Chris Singleton and our entire outstanding crew here at MLB The Show. I'm John Ciambi saying so long.
Our final line score tonight, first for the victorious Seattle Mariners, three runs on nine hits, no errors. They left 11 runners on base.